We'll give you the shirt off our back. If you fuck us, we'll kill every fucking thing you love. We don't give a fuck down to the sheep, bro.
That's the way he's supposed to be.
My first time on the bus, this lady was just talking shit about Russians. I don't even know what she's fucking speaking. There was a mob boss on the fucking bus with her right behind her. She's like, I was just here rushing, I'll smack one of those stupid fuckers.
What?
That's when I stood up, I said, would you say you fucking white bitch? I said, I'm Russian.
Right,
smack
right,
me.
Right.
Her husband got up, I knocked him up right fucking here. She's like, my son will get you. I smacked her fucking son. I said, call the police. Call him. I lifted my shirt, took my Kimber 1911. Yeah. I said, call him, I'll shoot the fucking bus.
1911? Call him,
smack. The bus driver's like, sir, you got it. I said, shut the fuck up and drive. I'll get off the next side. You got me fucked up.
This place ain't shit.
They encourage homosexuality in America. They encourage in Russia. We didn't legalize no fucking gay marriages.
You remember that video we was watching the Russian beating them fags ass?
Yeah.
Beating their ass.
I heard the one picture they beat up.
You won't find a gay person, you won't find a pedophile at all. You'll find straight fucking mob bosses.
Right.
Bad women.
They let men be men.
Exactly. In our prisons, there ain't no commissary, ain't no fucking TVs. I got to America at the prison, I said, man, this is a country club. I said, man, where I'm from, rats are coming out their fucking toilet the size of cats.
Hey, that's why a lot of people, they get locked up. They're not scared to do 10 years.
I did 14 and a half.
Damn, 14.
Oh, yeah. I did 2 years in Russian prison for murder, got off. Man's father. 2 years, they kicked me out the gate. My boss, good job, I'm going to go to America. I said, I go there and I conquered.
But you know what? America's prison systems, though, is... It's free slave labor, is what it is.
That's all it is, slave labor. I was going to say slave labor.
That's why the drugs, the government's the main one selling drugs.
There's just as much drugs in prison as there is on the streets.
Well, it's the government that makes the drugs.
Yeah. Well, people, this is what I tell people all the time. Black men, Hispanics are on the fucking jets. The government's flying in front. The CIA's flying all the heroin, all the coke.
All that
they
shit.
Did it to destroy the poor and the black and Hispanic community. That's right. When that shit got to the white community, then they fucking, we're on drugs.
Yeah, now with the heroin thing going out, now that they're saying heroin is an illness.
That's not no fucking illness. Yeah, illness. The government fucking put that shit on the street.
That's why they got the motherfucking military guarding the poppy.
Up in Afghanistan. Yeah. That's where they get that good shit.
The heroin only grows in 5 places in the world. Afghanistan, Pakistan, North Korea, South Korea, and fucking...
Mexico.
No, don't go to Mexico.
They grow poppies in Mexico.
No, they don't. They do not. Heroin,
look it up.
Heroin, I promise you.
It's not as high grade quality.
They can't grow it over there. Because they don't got the right irrigation to fucking, and the right chemicals to produce it. I'm trying to tell you.
I'm saying during World War II,
not no little nickel and dime shit. I'm talking about weight.
Right.
Mexico gets all their shit Colombians. They get all their drugs from the Colombians. The only thing that they can fucking grow in Mexico is marijuana. Where do you think the cocaine comes from? Not Mexico, from Colombia.
Right.
That shit's grown in Colombia, Peru, and Panama. The only 3 places cocaine goes from. I know what I'm talking about. I won't talk about something. I will not argue about something. I don't know what I'm talking about. I just shut the fuck up.
Well, I was just telling you, like, during World War II, there was a poppy shortage during World War II for morphine for the soldiers. So they did grow it in Mexico, if you looked at history up on it.
I got reset real quick. This is Job 10 and 22, talking about America, a land of darkness as darkness itself and as the shadow of death without any order. And where the light is as darkness. Going back to how America allowed faggots to walk around, women ruling over men. This is a place out of order.
This is what I don't understand. Like,
women above the man.
Where I come from, women don't run shit. The men's the fucking
king. That's how it should be.
The bitch stays in the house and cooks and cleans. We give her the money, she pays the fucking bills.
There you go.
Here they fucking, you give women a little opinion, they fucking think they're fucking gonna run the fucking show. Right. Fuck that. I wish a woman would tell me. Hey, bitch, get the fuck out of my house. Go find another sucker, because I ain't one of them.
They good at 911
here. Oh, yeah. I don't steal smack a bitch. Let her call 911. It gives me 5 minutes to beat the living brakes off her. Like,
they do that on purpose, though. They keep the man down, they keep the families divided.
And they wonder why the babies are growing up fucking either fags or disrespectful little motherfuckers, because they ain't got a man in the house to teach them right, but we're going to teach them how to be a man. They got... The thing is, they wonder why all this homosexuality... is because women are dating women and they're trying to have their partner raise their son into a man. You can't do that. A woman can't teach a man how to be to be a man. I'm sorry.
It's impossible.
It's impossible. You're going to raise a faggot. That's what you're going to raise.
Right. Yep. Right. And really, a woman can't even raise a woman either.
That's right.
A man got to raise a woman.
Man got to show a little girl.
Yeah, that's our job.
You know, how to be a little lady. Well, I mean, the women raise them. They show them how to raise themselves properly, stuff like that.
We got
to
lay down the law, though.
The basic shit.
To show them, like, look, you can't don't depend on a man for nothing. I got twin daughters who are 6 months old.
Yeah,
I send money home. Every 2 weeks, I send $1,500 home.
Yeah.
Even though I'm not married to my ex-wife, I give her money because that's the mother of my children.
Right.
I tell her before you, whatever you do, bitch, I want receipts to make sure my daughters got what they want. Whatever's left, you can have, but I want to make sure what you say, this is what I need the money for, that's what is going on. Because if it don't, I swear to fucking God, y'all show up at your fucking doorstep, beat the fuck out your husband, smack you, and take my kids back to
Moscow.
That's
what most of women do. They get that child support money, and they buying shoes, drugs.
Take care of the
child support money they're getting is only like $100, $200 at that. And the government's taking most and only giving them like
$30.
That's why this shit got to be destroyed.
It does.
It shit got to be. I pray. Get Putin on the phone.
Hey, Iskander missiles on their way.
All right, you seen the Satan II missile?
Them Topol M's.
You seen the Satan II missile? Russia's new missile they got? The Satan II is, they had the old Satan missile. Now they got Satan II. The missile, it has the missile has a built-in nuclear reactor.
It's beautiful, man. It's beautiful.
It's a missile that can fly non-stop.
Oh, yeah, I know what you're talking about. That,
yeah.
It's a cruise missile. That can fly from Russia to the U.S. with no problem.
And it can go around South America, go around, just keep going.
Cruise missile.
Yeah.
If he fucks with that little dude in North Korea, he's going to war with America. He said, you fuck with Bashar Assad in Syria,
I can't wait,
I'm going to war with you.
I can't
wait. He said, I'm not fucking playing with you. He said, you think that I'm scared of you motherfuckers? He's got China backing him.
Put them hooks in the jaw.
He's got North Korea, China, Japan, others backing Russia.
But then everybody. We got
is Israel, Britain, France.
Israel done. They're the biggest. Actually, Israel the biggest devils of them all.
Yeah, Israel's the one that started all shit. They're not the true Israelites.
Right, that's us. Actually, that's us.
They take them off their fucking land and build up their wall. Like, okay, now this is Palestine.
They heathens too, though. The real Israelites are so-called Black Latinos and Native Americans. And they're confusing the faces that could be scattered abroad like you were Israelite too.
Israelites, Indians, Blacks, mixed. That's how they get the darks, the lights. I don't really get into it, but I just...
Hey, let me show you a real scripture real quick. You said so. This is a good one right here. Check this one out. Revelation 2:9.
We're living in Revelations right now.
Are you right about that? Check this out. I know that works in tribulation and poverty, but thou art rich. And I know
sexy.
I know the black. Listen to this, though. He said, I know the blasphemy of them which say they are Jews and are not, but are the synagogue of Satan. So, yeah, even the Bible says that. You got Jews who say they are Jews but are not. They're lying. Yeah. And where the Jew sign go? The devil sign. They're the biggest pedophiles on the planet.
The Mormons and them Jews are the pedophiles.
They're the same people.
I went up to these homeless guys out here, man. There's a pizza. He said, I don't want it. I said, it's pepperoni. You can take the pepperoni off.
I mean, I appreciate it.
Guys will be out for hours. I'm saying, this food, man. I mean, I see someone, I just don't give it. I don't care. That's how you get your blessings. I don't want shit back.
That's right.
I see someone down on their luck, that could be me. That could be me next.
All right, that's good that you try to help us out, so. But what you say, the reason we don't eat, because we follow the Bible. And the Bible says we're not allowed to eat pork. So we don't.
That's the Quran.
No, it's in the Bible. They stole that from the Bible. And the Quran is just a ripoff. It's like a plagiarized Bible. You know
but
what
you
mean?
Still got a heart, your heart though.
Yeah, you got to go.
These motherfuckers want to give you a quarter to save your life.
Like, man, I don't care. Every time I get off the bus in the morning, I'm looking for homeless people. I give them give them each a coffee, like a little sandwich right here. It ain't much, but it's something.
Right. It's beautiful.
Like, I know you're probably not going to get nothing. You're probably going
to
buy beer with it, but at least I try to do something nice.
Hey. Sometimes you need beer.
You need beer.
Sometimes you need a bottle of liquor.
I need beer bottles.
I went to Walmart, spent $500 in my pocket for gloves, hats, blankets, pillows, and dropped them off. all down there, started walking in the one aisle and started hitting them out.
Okay.
You know, it's kind of like, you can't do that. I said, fuck off. Yeah,
they arrested you for that.
I got damn money.
Yep. Yep. They started arresting people.
Walk up on me, I guarantee you, motherfucker, I'll knock you out. The police are
right.
My country will kill you, motherfucker.
Right. They give you a ticket here, but they arrest you.
He said, oh, you have a bloody case, so I ain't fucking with you.
How was cops like, how are the cops in Russia? They don't go around fucking with people like that.
Hell no. All they want is they're like, give me money. You give them money, they fucking keep it going.
Right, but they don't like, in America, the cops just drive around looking for people to fuck with.
In America, they go around shooting innocent black men, children, women. They don't give a fuck. I'm trying to say, go take that shit to Russia and try and kill an innocent person. You don't get fucking fucked up.
That's why these people out here, they scared bitches really out here. Really.
Yeah, they're fucking cowards, man. Where I come from, you look, where I come from, the way I was raised, you look a man in the eye when you talk to him, you shake his hand, you do business.
Here you go.
To get respect, you gotta give him. If you look in my eye, you look away, I know you're a lying motherfucker, I'm gonna kill you.
Right.
Because I wanna know what the fuck you up to. That's just, it's respect with me.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Like, I don't care, you know, that's just me, man. It's
a family thing.
I'm from the old school. 41 years old, I look good for my age. Good. Work out, I don't do drugs, all I smoke is weed, that's it. I smoke that gas, that thrax.